Hello, welcome to another video on the channel. Now today I'm on the Tench Lake at Angler's Paradise. A bit of a new one for me. Now my old mucker Steve, he's fished here a few times, but I've never fished on this lake before. So this is a first. So I know it's got plenty of golden tench in it. A few other species, you know, like the goldenrod, goldfish. The usuals for Angler's Paradise. There's also some koi and carp in here. Koi carp and carp. And if we catch any of those, we've got to remove them from the lake and put them in a little holding tank. That's what they've asked, as they're not supposed to be in here. And there's probably a few other surprises in here as well. So let's get the kit ready and see what we can catch. Look at that. First golden tench. First one I've had in absolutely years because I haven't fished down at Angler's Paradise for quite a while now. Absolutely stunning fish. Lovely little black spots on it. Beautiful. Let's hope we can get a few more of these and slip him back.
It's just too nice to fish the tench here.
I've got a fish on. It's a massive grass carp.
Grassy?
I think so. Look like it. Again, chance of getting it in a slim. How's that? I'm getting everything.
I actually have a grass carp.
First thing I'm going to land it is it's big.
Let me come round and land it for you then. You can concentrate on the fishing.
Oh, if he goes into lilies, I am screwed.
Yeah, nice. I'll come this side. Take him for a walk. Nice.
I'm not going to weigh him actually, he's nowhere near. Well, I think.
This is all.
Here we go.
Fantastic.
Here we go.
Fantastic.
Look at that, that was not expected. Golden tench fishing. It's lovely. Lovely grass carp. Beautiful fish. Don't slip her back before she beats the absolute hell out of me anymore.
Do I weigh it quickly?
Might as well. I'd say he's probably about 5 pounds, six pounds.
I'll say it's big.
£7 on the nose. Now that fish put up a really hard fight. Just resting him in the net in the margins for a moment. he gets his energy back, because he's as knackered as I am and he's going to need it. Jibbly. I'm kind of hoping I don't get another one in. That was an absolute pain in the arse to get in on lighter line and a float rod. Not designed for that really, but this was good fun. Let's continue and see if we can actually get some more golden tench rather than a grassy and a koi that I lost, but not really the intended quarry. Let's continue. Simple kit I'm using today for the float lake, for God's sake. Very simple kit I'm using today on the Tench Lake. So it's just a float rod, fixed ball reel, fairly sizable waggler float, but very, very visible. Size 12 hook, and a couple of maggots. Just over dead depth, so it's probably about an inch along the, on the bottom. Lost one, I would, well, I assume it's a carp. So, turns out there's a fair few more carp in here than I think me and Steve thought. So I've just been snapped up by a carp in the lilies. Steve's had a couple of carp? Three?
Six.
Six carp. Steve's had six carp. Which is making the kind of lightish tackle next to the lilies kind of fishing interesting, to say the least. But hopefully some more golden tinge will come along and the carp will do well. Well, this is exactly what shouldn't be in here. Little common carp, crazy little fish, they go like mad for the size. Let's see if we can get them in a holding pond, well, the holding net, should I say. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. For God's sake, luckily the old mat's here. Is literal bar of soap. There we go, look at that, absolutely beautiful fish. Really, the eyes on him are incredible, like jet black, it's brilliant. Nice little mottled colour along the top, bit of white on the bottom. Beautiful. Let's slip her back. Actually, I should have weighed that one. It would have been, I think. No, that was clever of me. Standard. A bit windy. Brown goldfish. Pretty plump little fish. Lovely job. Look at that. It's fin up and everything. And a massive fin. It's like a bloody grayling. What a lovely fish. Typical male tench, he's got the older testicles on his side. Oh, absolutely stunning, it's slipper back. I don't actually know what they're called.
Yeah, well, that's it.
Technically.
I mean, yeah, you're not wrong. It's just, it's funny to say on a video, isn't it?
Yeah. Look at this tiny, tiny little rudd. Absolutely stunning. I've just had about 3,000 of them circling around in front of me, so I'm going to give it a minute and let them disperse, because I can't catch anything whilst they're there. Although there's some really, really bright orange ones, which could just be the very, very bright golden rudd. It could be orf, but the chances of catching those when all the others are rudd are probably pretty slim. But I would like a nice orf. I'm going to have a little break and come back to this when they've moved on. Tench love a worm. So do carp, though, sadly. Also will rudd, but they probably struggle to get this in their gob a little bit more than they would a couple of maggots. Oh, there we go. Whatever that was, it came off. But it wasn't a rudd. The problem is I can't feed anything if I put a handful of maggots in or small pellets in, those rudd will just swarm in front of me. So until I know they've disappeared, can't use any loose feed. Now this lake as well is very, very much a figment of Zig's imagination. Because if you was to look at this lake, the Tench Lake, on Google Earth or from a drone or anything like that, which is what I'm gonna do, you'll see it's actually shaped like a tench. So as far as I know, I don't think anyone else has a lake that is shaped like a tench. It really is fantastic. Another one of these fantastic little tench, getting obliterated on maggots. Well, and anything small, to be fair, at the moment. I switched over to worm and struggling to connect with anything. I was getting bites, just not, there's nothing there really when I struck it. Steve's just had a nice tench on the old prawn. So I thought, I'll give the prawn a go. And that was the first one. Obviously, hoping for a bit bigger, considering the size of the bait compared to the fish, but it is what it is, I'm happy catching anything. Been an absolutely fantastic day. Apart from me keep catching the brambles in front of me. What more could you ask for? I could say a glorious sunny day, but I'm not actually over keen on the sun, but where we're sat at the moment, it's actually starting to shade up quite nicely. Thank God. Let's just hope for a few more fish. There's no shortage of bites on the old prawn, that's for sure. It's just actually connecting, because the hook is semi-buried inside the prawn. Just to try and stop it from getting nicked by the little fish, really. But Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant fun. It really is. Oh, there we go. Missed that one. I can still see the swarms of rudd. But they can't really get a whole prawn in their mouth, that's for sure. Of fish. It's been a great day and it's been really nice to see behind me, sort of, well, where I was fishing, there's a pagoda, and on a pagoda was like a whole family. There was like the parents, the kids, all fishing, all having a good time. You could hear them all laughing and shouting when they were happy about catching a fish. It's just brilliant, absolutely brilliant to see. Really, really nice. A lot of people might get a bit angry, especially around carp lakes and things like that, with kids screaming around. But when you're in a place like this, really is good to see kids out there fishing. Magical. I'm just about to say if you come to the Tench Lake, but it should be a when you come to the Tench Lake here at Angler's Paradise. You look around and this lake is just covered in apple trees, which is obviously what the owner, Zig, makes his own wine. Whenever you stay here, you get a free bottle in your villa. It's quite strong stuff, so be prepared. Don't use it like normal wine. Don't pour yourself a huge glass because you will be on your back. It is strong. But all the wine is made from all the hedgerows here. You've got blackberries behind me. There's all kinds of things that's used in the wine every year, which is what always tastes slightly different. But it's magical stuff, believe you me. And quite a few of the lakes here at Angler's Paradise, you have a pagoda, like this one behind me here. We'll go and have a little look. This is primarily designed for the disabled angler, so they can come in here, all nice concrete grounds, nice and flat. And you can literally sit here and fish straight off the front of it. You've got nice little areas inside here which can be out of the wind and the rain. And yeah, look at this here. It looks absolutely stunning. You can sit here, beautiful lily beds to the right hand side. Absolutely perfect. And this is where the family was sat earlier, that I could hear in the background, the excited kids catching their fish. It's magical, absolutely magical. Well, here we go. Another cracking little golden tench from the Tench Lake here, Angler's Paradise. It's been an absolutely brilliant day. All kinds of fish, loads of golden tench, couple of rudd, monster blooming grass carp, and a few normal carp. What more could you ask for? So thank you very much for watching. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you on the next one.